Let's look at the parable of the Good Samaritan and see what the Bible says about these subjects. In Luke 10:25, Jesus had just stated that the two great commands are to love God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. He then illustrated the meaning of loving your neighbor. The man asked him, "Who is my neighbor?" And so he gave him the story. He said, "A man who was traveling from Jerusalem to Jericho was robbed, beaten, and stripped of his clothes, leaving him half dead. A priest and a Levite each saw him, but they passed by on the other side of the road. However, a Samaritan, a despised man to the Jews, saw him, and the Bible says that he had compassion on him. Well, he bandaged his wounds, poured medicine on him, put him on his animal, and took him to the inn where he spent the night taking care of him. The next day, he left the innkeeper with enough of his own money to pay for the man's room and board and any further treatment that he might need for his recovery. And then he promised even to come back and repay the innkeeper if it cost him any more than he was already given." John W. Robbins from the Trinity Review gives a great summary of the lessons from this parable. First, the political religious establishment, the priest and the Levite, seemed to be uninterested in actual health care because they passed on the other side of the road. And you kind of wonder, is the church as involved today in taking care of the poor as they were 150 years ago or 100 years ago? Or have we given up most of the control of this over to the government? Let's see as we continue talking. The Samaritan businessman paid the innkeeper for his trouble. He apparently didn't think that the innkeeper had an obligation to help him or the crime victim without being paid. The Good Samaritan didn't hold the belief that just because someone has a need, that it creates an entitlement to the property of someone else. In other words, just because I'm injured doesn't mean somebody is obligated to give free services to me. He acted out of compassion, not out of compulsion. He didn't try to compel anyone else to be kind either. The Samaritan businessman spent the night in the inn with the victim, making sure that the man would recover. And after the emergency was passed, he just continued on his trip, leaving the victim in the care of the innkeeper. This showed a level of personal involvement, personal care that he displayed. And it was an actual open display of love, which no doubt brought great pleasure to the injured man and to the Samaritan. And it was a great example to the innkeeper as well. The Good Samaritan didn't organize a lobby to agitate for a national health care plan, because that has nothing to do with loving your neighbor, because loving your neighbor is a personal issue. Instead, he continues about his business. This traveling Samaritan was the good neighbor by sharing both his own goods and his own time with the crime victim. And it's his example, not that of the political and religious leaders, that Christ commands us to imitate.